Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we are going to be continuing Red Dead Redemption. I'm not going to say too much, so make sure you subscribe, turn on post notifications, give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed, and let's get into it. I did a Red Dead. The volume was pretty low, so I fixed it, I think. So hopefully it's a little bit easier to hear. Pretty sure this is where we have to give that guy his note from that girl. Oh, wrong way.
Family business coming through.
You're good.
Son of a gun.
You got my money?
Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. It'll cost you. I can't be bothered. Here, take it.
Thank you, Arthur. Thank you. My God. What a woman. This'll get her killed for sure.
What?
Women's suffrage. Around here, they don't even like men voting. Bring back the monarchy, given half the chance. Progress is a dirty word in these parts. Unlike incest.
Excuse me?
I don't want to marry my cousin Matilda. I want to marry Penelope. But they'll kill her at one of those rallies they're holding. They've done it before. Mr. You gotta help.
No, I'm afraid I don't want no part of it.
I'll pay. My family. We've still got some money.
Fine. Just no more running around with letters.
Thank you. Come on. We better get going.
Oh, great.
Round up, all right. Follow me to Rhodes.
Come on! Come on!
Yeah! We'll go around the property and take the road to town.
Easy, boy. Calm down.
I can't be calm. If we don't get there in time, my true love may be shot.
If she wants to rally, you gotta let her rally.
Well, good as the cause is, I can't let her become a martyr to it. I want to marry a flesh and blood woman, not a statue in her honor.
I'm sure they know what they're doing.
There they are.
Bo, what are you doing here?
I cannot let you go through with this. You'll be killed.
I'm prepared to die for the cause, Bo. You know that.
Do something, please.
Do what? Fight this mob?
We must begin.
They need me alive.
This is no laughing matter, sir. They need protecting from certain elements. Mostly my family. Penelope, I beg you.
I'll tell you what. Your friend here can drive the wagon for us. It'll allow us to shout all the louder.
Hooray!
Sure.
Miss Calhoun.
Oh, so
Miss Calhoun.
Yes?
My friend here says he can drive the wagon.
Well, Olive Calhoun. Normally I like to drive myself, but today I feel like a man joining us sends the right message.
Well, I ain't never been in a protest march before, madam.
Well, just treat us like the sheep and the folks attacking us like the wolves, and I'm sure you'll feel right at home. Shall we go? All right, ladies. We know our song is a good one, and we know our cause is a pure one.
Yes, ma'am.
Let liberty reign!
We'll mothers, wives, housekeepers, and daughters. We cook the food and we fetch the water.
Take us down Main Street, right through town to the steps of the Bank of Rhodes, Mr.
What was your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
Well, they'll hear it all right.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Are you an old friend of the movement?
I'm just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Well, our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan. Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
I believe you might be right.
Good day, Sheriff. I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly. Oh, do give it a rest, you sorry fool. Mr. Morgan, I give you the male of the species.
Yeah, it's a pretty dumb specimen, I grant
it. A little further, please. Stop just past the bank. This spot is fine, sir.
Ladies! Get down!
Come on! Come on.
Go home!
Shut your mouth!
What are you doing?
The hell is going on?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is a great day for all of us. For today is the day we begin to live as equals.
Equals!
Yes, equal, sir. Fair and equal.
This is unnatural. This is nonsense.
Fair, equal, and and free, just as the Founding Fathers intended.
Founding Fathers, not Founding Mothers, you silly old goat.
His philosophy dependent on biology.
What the hell are you doing here, boy?
Keep your voice down. I'm trying to listen to the speech.
Hello, darling cousin.
Don't you ever speak to me like that.
What are you doing here?
Listening, I suppose.
Go help Bo. His cousin is a moron. And stop them from ruining the speech.
You need to learn yourself some manners, cousin.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, you always was.
Bo, weren't we just leaving?
Who the hell is this?
Follow me, Ron.
Oh, what? You'll hit me?
Come on.
Sir, can you not see how idiotic you are?
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
We are all Americans.
We gotta go before they think twice. Oh, Lord. America. Follow me. I know a place. It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
You don't want to go back and hear the speeches? I ain't voted before, but I'm kind of getting hot for voting rights.
I don't know whether to take you seriously, Mr. Morgan.
I wouldn't.
My cousins are my primary concern right now. If everyone knows about Penelope and me...
Everyone knows about Penelope and you? I know about Penelope and you, and I've been here all of 10 minutes. Sooner it's out, sooner it's resolved.
The sooner it's dealt with, you mean? We're dealt with. Our families, the Greys and the Braithwaites, we bury our secrets, and we bury them deep.
Secrets and your treasure.
You know, Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter. No one's seen her in years. She were right, you know, and Penelope said...
I ain't heard about daughters. I heard about gold.
But Yankee gold? I fear that's just a story, Mr. Morgan. And I don't know.
This is awful!
Nobody died. It ain't that awful.
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but...
You should leave.
I will, as soon as I have enough money. When my family... We have money, but I don't.
Is your family very rich?
Yes. Well, I believe so. But, they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a... artistic temperament, so...
Well, is that what they call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke. I really love her. I do.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
Look, I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment. Thank you. Excuse me.
That wasn't too hard. $30.
Hey,
you know, you could at least give him like 40 or 50. Abigail. Let's see what she wants. Is it going to be about John? I feel like it's going to be about John. Normally it is with her. That or Jack. Thanks.
Hey, Arthur.
What's going on?
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said you knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Hosea wants you to join him instead. Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
We're still only on chapter 3, right?
Hey, Arthur, what are you doing?
Selling it back to where it came
from. Every time.
Well, I ain't got a market for it. They made it, they must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. All I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Is this that one place we were just at not too long ago and we shot people and all that?
Here we are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it?
Hello, gentlemen, how are you? What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity.
I mean no harm. No harm at all.
You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. Okay. Well, she's at the house.
Help yourself, why don't you?
We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please. Some liquor?
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Oh. Relax, I ain't here to rob you. Oh, it seems that's easy enough. Why don't do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
Only a dollar?
You get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it, at least not without orders.
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff in the road, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
Alright.
Don't know what that is, but sure.
Here we go.
I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me.
Yeah. All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing, Tristan. You know my feelings about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Oh, sir, please.
I'm the clown. You're the brother turned idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
Hey, what about you?
Shh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. Right. Broke poor Mammy's heart. There, there, Fenton. There, there. Don't get mad now. I think we're going the wrong way here.
No, really? Oh my god, these horses are so hard to turn.
What now, Alfred? You sure this is the way?
No, just shut up. Oh my god.
Shit, wagon's stuck. Which way are you taking us? This doesn't look right. Are we heading in the right direction? Just take it easy, we'll do all that. Okay, Fenton,
and stay calm now. Come on, I should lose your soul.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour?
Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton.
Rude.
Just hand out the liquor.
Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him.
This way! are coming after us.
When I see them,
well, shoot them then.
You think we weren't fighting? You think I'm trying to do, bro? Nice. Is that it?
Don't think so.
Thank God. Whew. That was fun.
Too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite, see what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Ben. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch. So, what do you think?
About what?
Fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something ain't nobody gonna know we was here. Because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them. Or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
Well, how the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side. And then we rob our oath. Before they figure out it was us that got it, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback.
I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something. Now, if you will excuse me, Arthur, I got to write a letter.
I'll go here. I think it's closer, so why not? We actually get some sleep first. Where's my horse? There you are.
Fellas, I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough. Move along now.
Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he's big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big, but his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think...
That's fair. I'm turning it down a tiny bit. That should be good. Wait.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we could take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you with a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle on earth? Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
That's fair.
Hop on. We'll fill you in on the way.
No, I'm driving.
Fine. All right, let's get this over with.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of a horse. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. A smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep, using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook now, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right fella for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. They're really burying some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still. Tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yeah.
You can see his gun through the top.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand. Some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink, Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? Then you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said there were some of our drivers in town. I jumped at the chance.
I never been a fella to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. A bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy. Because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Well, the average man sups on shite, yeah? Yeah, yeah. Okay. Hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine. We light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained. And that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
I should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm a rebel stock boy. I was born burning down manor houses.
Burn quietly.
There's someone coming on the left.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed in the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Harold.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
Just let me deal with our friend here. Come on. You douse the fields. I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble.
Oh frick, how the heck am I gonna get by? I'll just wait for him to go back the other way. I'll wait. Not taking a chance.
Show yourself. Hey.
You, how the frick did you even see me? I was hiding behind the stuff, so how the frick did you see me? Well, okay then. Let's see where it leaves me off at. And of course, I'm gonna have to do them all again. Because why would it save a little bit of it?
Do it.
This is where I messed up last time, so I'm gonna stay farther away so I don't get caught. If this guy knows how to walk. That was close. I almost screwed that up. Oh, that did not tickle.
Here come Lord of them.
get us paid real well for this.
Bloody right.
All right, come on, we'll take those horses.
We'll have to see if the payroll was actually in there.
Hurry up.
Oh, boy. We did good, boy. We did good.
Hey, but let's go. Get the hell out of here, fast!
You right, follow me!
Touch has put us into the middle of here.
I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Might as well. I think there's another mission probably up there.
Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
Some business in town. Come on. Okay.
I'm gonna save it real quick. Oh, you can't save it. Okay, cool.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. As soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's... easy.
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house.
There's some blood here. That ain't good.
Found anything? Big struggle. Pretty recently,
look,
I'd say.
Tracks.
Guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet.
Let's go, boy.
They went down the...
up here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get shot, after the bar fight,
I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
I still ain't sure about that. Whoa! Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say. Excuse me.
Yeah?
You seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
All right, you two.
Where the hell is...
You both better get out of here!
Come here!
I like how he's right on the other guy's head.
Where is Trelawney?
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay. Okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Let me see you again, you hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a...
At least we're still on the good path so far.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
Yeah, that's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's a special talent. Keeping fish on the line.
Dang, where the frick are we going? It's like in the middle of nowhere.
That must be it.
Oh. Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen.
I can handle this.
Boom. Nice shot.
Far.
He's mine! Let me take him. And get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet.
Oh, okay, cool.
Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you.
Of course. You okay?
Yeah. Fine.
Hopefully.
All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure, what's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
You okay? Oh, you're right.
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
There always seems to be more and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it. But even that ain't the way I remember it.
Dang, some time must have gone by. Alright, so I think that will be it for this video. Let me save it. Let's see where we are at. So we were at 30%. Let's see. We only went up 1.2%. Wow, this is going to be a long game. Okay, so let me full screen it. Alright, thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, turn on post notifications, give this video a big thumbs up. Make sure you check out all my other videos. I've been making a lot of gaming videos lately, and I've been posting a lot of hashtag shorts. So make sure you check those out as well, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.